Good morning. Let's do a little stretch together. It's good to see everyone. Glad you're here. I need some yoga this morning. It's September and we need to do this together. Get in shape for the fall and for the winter. And just feel our bodies. Inhale up again. Glad to do this with you about time. Namaste, everybody. Beautiful wellness friends. Let's do this. Take a deep breath in. Relax your shoulders. Good. Let's go to posture. Take your hands down to your feet. And feet hip width. Just breathe into your belly. Deep breath in. Exhale slowly. Standing for a little bit. Kind of feeling the mat, feel the bottom of your feet. Feel a long line just lifting you up from the inner thighs all the way through. A long feeling all the way up to the sky. Relax your shoulders. Just let your shoulder blades stream down your back all the way down towards your feet and ankles. Just relax it. And one more deep breath. Exhale slowly. Just keep it deep breathing. One more time. Here we go. Lift up. Grab your wrist and going sideways. And lift up. Inhale. Going sideways. Lift up. Inhale. Going back, not your shoulders, but just your heart up to the sky, right? Lift, roll, out of sight. Here we go. Just grab and go over to the side, just for a lengthening feeling. You can even lean a little bit out to the side and just push the hip out. Inhale up, lift up on the side, over and sideways. Inhale up. Exhale, roll, lift. Now this time, we're just gonna sit a little bit in the knees, knees over your toes, and sit back a little bit in a chair pose here. Now from the side, what I'm gonna watch, out four, and then I can bring my weight a little bit to my heels. If this doesn't feel good for you, just shake your hands to your legs, sitting here. And let it all slide down and hang out right here. Keep your knees soft. And your arms down. Maybe you have to even an arm up. Opposite knee bends to help you out for a big twist. Reach up to the sky. Take it back. On the side. One knee. Opposite arm. And take it back here. Walk up nice and slow. Round up to make sure that you're round. Take your shoulders back. Lift up one more time. Exhale into the chair pose. Good. You can also try your balance. Exhale forward. Release right here. Head out. Just feeling. Now we're just slowly rolling up. Take my arms all the way back up. Now one more time and then we stay there. All the way back. Take it all the way down. Crumble all the way to the floor. Be careful with your back. And from here we're going to walk it out. Step it out. Take a deep breath. And go into that really nice down dog stretch right here. Feeling that you're lowering your heels to the floor. Shake it out, no stress in the shoulders and neck. Deep breath and just lifting up a few times. Exhale. nice and slow. Hang it out right here.
Roll up slowly.
Inhale up. Take it back down. Good. Check your posture. Nice deep breath. One more time. Inhale. Float back. Just gentle float back. Inhale. Just gentle to your floor. Bend your knees. Hang it out. Fingers spread. And step it out. Walk it out right here. Down dog. Downward facing dog. And now if you want a big stretch in your upper body, just bring your chest a little bit through it. While you're bringing your heels to the floor. Then come all the way forward. Let's try that plank here and move around to the plank a little bit. Make sure you bring your shoulders over your hands. Push back, exhale. Inhale, core, remember? Strong in the abs. So really watch your lower back. Stay in place there. Move it around a little bit. Feeling those abs. Push back, exhale. And through the down dog, feels so good. Inhale, plank right here. Hold it, make sure that you have a nice straight lower back with a cup of coffee. Bring your knees to the floor. And release. Take your hands with you the first time. Take it all the way. Sometimes I have my knees a little further open. Just relax in the child pose. Make sure you tuck your nose in. You can use a block if you want to. Sometimes we do that. To put your head up. If you want to try it out, take your block. Come a little bit further with your arms and stretch your upper body right here. Really feeling that stretch in my shoulders, arms. And now you come up all the way. Do it one more time. Here we go. And push back into the heel. Step it up. Lift your tailbone to the sky. And then now press up your tailbone towards your heels. So really feeling that long stretch in your hamstrings, calves, down the legs towards the floor. No stress in your neck, just holding it tight. Inhale up. Towards the leg. Building a little bit of strength here in our routine. Exhale down. Lay the back. All I always like to say, just kind of play with that block. Feel what feels good here. Or like I said, you can place it underneath your head and take your arms backwards in your child pose. That feels good. If you do that, then your head's a little bit supported, right? So it feels better sometimes because then you're a little higher than your heart. So you don't have to put your head all the way down on the floor. So we're using the block sometimes to sit on or lean towards it and now do the bottom of your feet stretch right here. So from the all fours, curl your toes under, move your weight back. Come onto the heels right here and hold it. Abs are in. Pull your abs in because then you feel that strong core supporting you. If this is not really comfortable, sometimes you can even sit on the block a little higher. Really feel that weight shifting backwards to stretch the bottom of your feet. If you stretch the bottom of your feet right here and you feel, that's good for plantar fasciitis. Plantar fasciitis. Bottom of your feet. Especially if you're standing all day. Or if you're using and walking around in the same shoes that we're not supposed to. Yes, use the block here if you have one. Stepping forwards. Lean out towards the block. And with your lower back forwards towards the hamstring stretch right here. Into the leg. Stay with your hip over the knee. Bring your belly towards the upper leg. Sometimes it hurts a little bit more. A lot more if you pull those toes all the way up the plantar flexion. And then you slowly walk on your hands. Put your weight into your hands and walk forward towards the leg. So here is where we have our deep hip stretch. If you want that support, put it next to you. Lean out forward towards your foot in the front. So here our intent is that we're really stretching out here as we like to do because we sit down a lot. We want to stretch the hip flexors here and lean out towards the front. If you can put your hand to the side, sometimes even a little bit more to the side of the mat, then I can lean out even more and roll that way. You want to take it all the way down into a super twist. Feel your back there, right? Now push up and lean over the front leg here. And just take it all the way back up. Switch sides. Good. Shake it out. And lean onto your block. Step out with your other foot forward. Now lift yourself all up and over towards the left. Exhale. Pull your foot up as much as you can. Really feel the big stretch here, leaning over your leg forwards. Holding it for about 3 breaths. And then I want to place my weight, remember, on my hands. Just don't roll over your knee, right? So lift yourself up forwards. And go hang into the front leg. Place your weight if you want to again. Just lean onto your block if that helps. Just be a little playful with it. Or put your elbow on the block or on the floor. Now this is really far and deep into that stretch. That's up to you. If that's easy for you, just gonna push the knee away a little bit. Stretch out right there. Or, as I just did, put your hand to the side of the mat. Really hang out into that side again. So really feel here into that hip stretch. And also feel the hamstring all the way back. Just hold it for a little breath. And breathe slowly back. Inhale, use your block to walk back. Exhale, lean forwards. Just not upper body only, but from the lower below legs, right? Into the hamstring, glutes, and lumbar spine area of your back right here. And take it back. And twist it all the way back into your child pose. Lean over forwards. Bring your arms in. towards your heels, just roll it all in. And then come up slowly up. And shake it out a little bit in all fours. Maybe a little cat and cow pose. Last one here for your back. We're going to take a big stretch here into a twist from all fours. Bring your hand underneath and your shoulder to the floor. Walk your upper arm out. Smile, remember. You gotta look sexy all the time while you're doing it. Let's take a deep breath right here. Exhale slowly. Feeling that upper back twist. Through the eye of the needle. Slowly pull back in. Push yourself up, right? Check it out. And then I want to take the other side. All the way. Eye of the needle. Oh. Walk out. And then release a little bit here. Breathe in. Exhale, breathe out. Breathe in. Slowly move forward. Come to all fours. Shake it out. And come all the way back up into the down dog. Finishing all the way up here. And do what you can to work the plank into the chaturanga. Shoulders down, cobra. Curl yourself. Exhale. Finishing with this. Inhale. If you want to, just protect your back here. Take it on your knees down. Stay right there, inhale, exhale here, and take it all the way back through, maybe to all fours, yes? I'm going to show you that right here, inhale, all fours, lower, arms, strong shoulders, pull your shoulder blades back and down, and then back to all fours first. Abs are in, connected. Exhale down low. Yes, if you want to do that rather on all fours first, do that first, or go with me in the whole version. Last one. Exhale here, walk out a little bit. Slowly walk it up. Hang it out. Roll up slowly. Roll your shoulders back. Wasn't that good? Exhale down. Good. A little intermediate here. Still work out for us this morning. Starting September off with a good little stretch. Keep being very careful. Ask me questions. Let me know. Namaste. Have a wonderful blessing.